Oke, okay, hello. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So, here we're going to do the weekly English podcast here with our new speaker that will talk about social media. So, before we start, I'm gonna introduce myself first. So, my name is Gazal Narayana Sabrinarto, and I will be the host in this program. Okay. So, maybe you can introduce yourself for the speaker.
So, my name is Ahmad Raka Banyuwaji. You can call me Raka. So, on this podcast, I will be the speaker.
Yeah. Okay. So, we're going to talk about social media, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, is there a good impact of social media?
Oh, as you know. Of course. Social media, yeah, I think everything in this world is made for a good reason. Yeah. So, social media, of course, is a good thing. Yeah. I will tell maybe three good impacts. So, the first impact is you can get information faster. Yeah. In the old days, you can get the information like in the Well magazine. Yeah. But now we have social media. You just need to open your phone and then scroll through and search for the new information. And then the second good impact that we can contact our friends faster, yeah, instantly. The old place, yeah, you need to have a telephone, yeah, in your home, and you need the wire thing to the other home, yeah, and even more the old days. That you need to make a letter and it will go to your friend's home like 3 or more days. Yeah. Okay. Now it can do instantly. And the third, the third that you can share your experience faster. So you can also make an advertisement faster because now almost, yeah, I forgot how much the population of humans in the world use social media. Yeah. So when they scroll, maybe they accidentally found your advertisement, so they can get interested with your product or something. Yeah, so it's very good.
Okay, so thank you for the explanation. And if there was the good thing on social media, is there a bad thing or the dark side the other about social media?
Of course, social media also has a bad impact on for the user, like. In the social media, there's a lot of good impact, but there's also the bad impact. So, the first bad impact that you can search the bad one also. I mean, yeah, usually if you go to social media and you scroll, there's a chance that you will find bad content like NSFW content, yeah, you know, and the adult content, yeah. So you need to avoid that. And the second bad impact that there's a lot of haram things also. Like you can akhwat easier, yeah. So it is haram, but in now era it is very easier. Like you can just open your social media and then chat with girls. Yeah, it's not good. Yeah, and the third is in social media, there's a lot of gambling or yeah, like gambling sites. And yeah, easily it makes our when there's the ads, like do you want to get 100 million? Yeah, it makes our brain want interested to it. And it can trap us into gambling or maybe riba. Yeah.
Okay. So thank you for Raka for explaining the bad side of social media. And as I know, yeah, there was a bad things too, and there was a good thing on social media. And maybe I will ask you again, what about your experience on social media? Is there what is the good thing that you got from social media, and what is the bad thing?
So the good thing on social media, as my experience, yeah. So as I said before, that yeah, usually a lot of information comes up when we scroll through the social media, yeah. And it's also a very good impact, and we can know more about the world, yeah. As my experience, that yeah, in social media, usually we can ask to, if you know that we are confused in our religion, yeah, religion like is fasting Ramadan halal? Yeah, if we don't know, yeah, we can chat the Ustaz. Yeah, if in the old days that we need to like use, and we need to go to the Ustaz home and very long, yeah. Now we can just chat him. And yeah, the second is in social media that we can upload content. Yeah, we can also upload the good content to for at like dakwah content to dakwah the other people, like dakwah poster, you know, and dakwah video. Yeah, there's a lot of good impact that I've experienced. And for the bad impact, bad experience, I think maybe there is no, yeah, because inshallah I use the social media correctly, goodly. Yeah.
Okay, so for social media, is there a type of social media that maybe the apps, you can explain the apps of social media, like at on the picture you put Instagram, Discord, and the other. Can you explain what those apps?
Okay, so as you know that there's the first is, you know what, Instagram. Yeah, so Instagram, the app is actually like about the, yeah, there's a lot of content there, but usually it mostly the dominant is a photo content. So like there's also a video, but more dominant is the photo. But there's also the Reels mode. Yeah, in the Reels, yeah, you can scroll through the video. Yeah, so in Instagram you can also chat to a person, and you can also upload story like usual what social media. Yeah, and then the second, Discord. So Discord is also social media, but it more dominant to chatting chatting social media. Like, you know, before the Instagram, usually we can explore content, but Discord, yeah, it's almost same, not almost, like similar to WhatsApp, that we can chat a person, direct message them, and we can find a channel like the community. Yeah, so Figma is dominant to chatting, but it goes more to the community. If the WhatsApp, maybe you can use it as a personal use, but if Discord, yeah, we can use it for the community. Yeah, and maybe TikTok, yeah, you know TikTok, right? So TikTok is also the app that dominant to a video, to a video content. So in TikTok, most of them is a video content, yeah. And but I don't recommend using it if, yeah, because inside TikTok, yeah, it's only a little the good things. Yeah, it's better Instagram. And also there's the TikTok has a lot of useful feature too, also like chatting, but it's not that good the feature. And there's also the shop. Yeah.
Okay. So maybe thank you, Raka, for answering my question. And now, as I know, we're at IDN, and yes, is there a rules about social media? Maybe the rules that makes some of the social media is we cannot enter that social media about that.
Oh,
that because there was a good thing and a bad things at that social media. Can you explain?
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah. So yeah, we are at IDN, you know, and IDN also have rules for social media. So like we know that social IDN is usually IDN use a lot of social media on a daily activity like Instagram and YouTube. Yeah, I think actually IDN is allowing us to use the social media, but for the good things. Yeah, because we don't know what will happen inside the social media. Like when we open Instagram, we don't know what will come up to our home. Yeah, to our recommended things. Yeah, so that's why IDN is kind of forbid us to use the social media, like also YouTube. Like sometimes the ads is the bad one. So yeah, actually the main problem of social media is the ads. It's actually depend on the user. Yeah, because if the user search the good one, maybe inshallah it will appear the good one. But like if the user always search the bad things like NSFW things, yeah. So it will appears the bad things. So in IDN, yeah, we can only use social media to upload our project and maybe to search competition and the good information, as I know.
Okay. So, Raka already explained about the things or the rules at IDN about social media. And what about the social media that IDN forbid us? Is there anyone that ever try to open it, or maybe can you explain about the social media
forbid.
that makes IDN forbid?
Okay, maybe usually as usual, all schools have rules, and most of them they forbid to open social media. So, what are social media that IDN forbid us? So, most of them, this is the new rule that IDN forbid Pinterest. So Pinterest is actually a good social media, because in Pinterest, it has a little chance to us to communicate with other users, because Pinterest usually is most dominant to the content. Yeah, usually in Pinterest we search the contents for our idea. Yeah, so and I don't know why IDN forbid us, but maybe because sometimes in Pinterest, always appears the bad one, like girl. Yeah, so like we need to avoid that, but maybe because our teacher don't want us to be the bad one, so maybe they forbid us. Yeah, and then the second I think is WhatsApp. Yeah, since WhatsApp is not really important in IDN, yeah, for the student, yeah, for the teacher, they mostly use WhatsApp.
It's for chatting. Like
yes. So in WhatsApp, they think that they will know us that we will chat with our friend. Yeah. So IDN forbid us, because also in WhatsApp, IDN cannot, but IDN cannot control us. But they can make own group, yeah, like for playing or the others. Yeah, so I don't know exactly why IDN forbid WhatsApp. Yeah, and then maybe the third one, of course, TikTok. Yeah, we cannot open TikTok in IDN, because there's no connection between IDN and TikTok. Yeah, as you know, like Instagram, we can still upload our content, and WhatsApp, maybe we can share something to the teacher using WhatsApp. And the first one, I forget. Yeah, I have Pinterest. Yeah, maybe we can still permit to teacher to search idea in Pinterest, but TikTok, is the most forbid. Yeah, so in TikTok, there's a lot of bad contents, and mostly that's why I think the teacher forbid us to open it.
Okay, so thank you, Raka. And for the next question, is there a consequence when we do or we open the social media? The consequence that you get?
Is it, the consequences, I think it depends on the teacher and it depends on the rule. So like the first rule, the first rule that if someone open that social media, that IDN forbid us, they will usually like take the laptop or like ban the student that opened it. And there's also the rules that it's actually depend on the teacher, like our teacher, that if someone open the like social media, they will make all of us, our one class, get banned for maybe 2 weeks or 1 week, I forget. And there's also the punishment that like we can get bald, or we can get reminding letter. So actually the consequence is depend on the teacher, like, and usually like the teacher, like if they still care with the student, they use like maybe just get banned. But if the teacher already like angry, maybe they can search the law, the law book, and they will maybe like make you bald or give you reminding letter, call your parents. Yeah, usually like that.
Okay. So, you've explained about the consequence that we got at IDN, and next, maybe the last, for the last, is there an alternative apps or social media that we can use? Like last time you explained about WhatsApp, that we cannot open WhatsApp because it's kind of useless for us, but it's important, right, to chatting yes. someone. Is there an alternative?
Okay, so, yeah, the alternative. So, for the, you know, the what? I will maybe just choose two, yeah. So, the first is the social media for chatting, yeah. So, as you know, like, I didn't forbid WhatsApp, but there's the software that we can use. It is Google Chat, yeah, because it is, I don't know, I think it's safe, and the teacher can control us. Yeah, and like the alternative or of maybe TikTok. If TikTok, I think I don't really know about the alternative because in IDN we usually don't watch video. Yeah.
Okay.
So I think maybe just that the Google product, like as an example, Google Chat. And sometimes Discord. Yeah, Discord. Yeah, in the old IDN, yeah, the teacher use Discord to connect with us. Like we can chat. The teacher using Discord, and yeah, there's the Discord server of IDN. Yeah, so I think that's all.
Okay, so maybe thank you for Raka for explaining about social media. So maybe we're just going to close this podcast.
Yes, this podcast.
By reciting Hamda.
Alhamdulillah.
So thank you guys for watching.
Yes.
I'm Gazwan Raya Sabrindarto, and here's the speaker Raka.
Yeah, I'm
maybe
Raka.
We're going to close this podcast by saying salam.
Okay. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.